Dear students, welcome to eShikshana program. In my last two classes, I discussed and solved problems on binomial probability distribution. In today's class, let me consider another discrete probability distribution, namely Poisson probability distribution. Poisson probability distribution is a widely used distribution for a discrete random variable such as number of telephone calls per hour coming into the switchboard, number of traffic accidents per week in a city or state, number of patients arriving at a hospital every hour, number of cars waiting for service in a workshop, and so on. Poisson distribution can be obtained as a limiting form of binomial distribution. So, Poisson distribution as limiting form of binomial distribution. Poisson distribution is a limiting case of binomial distribution under the following conditions. 1. N, the number of trials, is indefinitely large, that is N tending to infinity. 2. P, the constant probability of success in each trial is very small, that is P tending to 0. 3. N into P is equal to a finite constant lambda. So N into P is equal to lambda. So then P can be written as lambda by N, and Q can be written as 1 minus P, 1 minus lambda by N, where lambda is a positive real number. So these are the conditions to obtain Poisson distribution as a limiting form of binomial distribution. Okay, so let us derive the probability mass function for the Poisson distribution as a limiting case of binomial distribution. If X is binomially distributed random variable with parameters N and P, then probability mass function for the binomial distribution is P of X is equal to R is equal to NCR P power R Q power N minus R for R 0 to N. So P of X is equal to R, or simply we can write P of R. So P of R is equal to, so writing for NCR, so N into N minus 1 into N minus 2 etc etc, N minus R minus 1 divided by factorial R into P power R into Q power N minus R. So substituting for P, P lambda by N, and Q 1 minus lambda by N, so this will be P of R is equal to N into N minus 1 into N minus 2 etc etc, N minus R minus 1 divided by factorial R into lambda by N power R for P. For Q, it is 1 minus lambda by N, so 1 minus lambda by N power N minus R. So there are R factors, 0 to R minus 1, so R factors, so there are R n's. So if we take out N from each factor, so this can be written as N into N into 1 minus 1 by N, N into 1 minus 2 by N, etc., etc., N into 1 minus R by R minus 1 by N. So if we simplify like this, we can obtain, so since there are R n's, so N power R can be written very conveniently, N power R into 1 into 1 minus 1 by N into 1 minus 2 by N, etc., etc. Simplifying this lambda by N power R, this can be written as lambda power R by N power R, as written here, lambda power R by N power R. So this N power R and this N power R, we can cancel. So therefore, we can conveniently write it as lambda power R by factorial R into 1 into 1 minus 1 by N into 1 minus 2 by n, etc., etc., 1 minus r minus 1 by n into 1 minus lambda by n raised to the power n minus r. Okay. So this quantity, 1 minus lambda by n power n minus r, can be written as 1 minus lambda by n power n into 1 minus lambda by n power minus r. So this lambda power r, factorial r, is written here, and this n power r and this n power r will get cancelled. So now, for large n, r as n tends to infinity, so limit as n tends to infinity of the left hand side is equal to lambda power r by factorial r is constant. So this into limit n tends to infinity of from here to here into limit n tends to infinity of this term into limit n tends to infinity of this term. So that's what is written here. Limit n tends to infinity of p of x is equal to r is equal to lambda power r by factorial r into limit as n tends to infinity from here to here, into limit as n tends to infinity of this term 1 minus lambda by n power n into limit as n tends to infinity of 1 minus lambda by n power minus r. Now, we can easily notice, as limit n tends to infinity, 1 by n, 2 by n, r minus 1 by n, all tends to 0. So I get 1 into 1 into 1 into 1. So this contributes 1. Then further, limit as n tends to infinity, 1 minus lambda by n power minus r tends to 1 again. As n tends to infinity, lambda by infinity, this is 0. Lambda by n is 0 as n tends to infinity. So 1 power minus r, that is 1. And further, limit as n tends to infinity of 1 minus lambda by n power n is nothing but e power minus lambda. E power minus lambda, because limit as n tends to infinity of 1 plus x by n power n is e power x. So substituting all this here, so what happens? Probability of x is equal to r is equal to lambda power r by factorial r. This is 1, this is 1, and this is e power minus lambda. So we are left with, probability of x is equal to r is equal to e power minus lambda into lambda power r by factorial r, where r takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., etc., etc. So this is the probability mass function of Poisson probability distribution. Okay. So consider this note. If the parameter n and p of a binomial distribution are known, we can find the distribution. But in situation where n is large, very large, and p or q very small, application of binomial distribution is very tedious. In such cases, it is advisable to use Poisson probability distribution to find the desired probabilities. So basically, when n is very large and p is very small, so computation of coefficients, terms, binomial terms will be very difficult. So therefore, we have to adopt Poisson distribution in cases where p is very small and n is very large. Mean and variance of Poisson distribution. Mean, E of x. For a discrete random variable, mean E of x is equal to sigma x into px. So we have replaced x by r. So sigma r from 0 to infinity r into pr. So sigma r from 0 to infinity r into substitute for p of r from the probability mass function of Poisson distribution, that is e power minus lambda into lambda power r divided by factorial r. So e power minus lambda is free from r, so that can be written outside. So e power minus lambda into summation r from 0 to infinity r into lambda power r by factorial r. So e power minus lambda into, when r expanding this summation, when r is 0, first term is 0, plus when r is 1, lambda power 1, that is lambda divided by factorial 1, plus when r is 2, 2 into lambda square by factorial 2, when r is 3, 3 into lambda cube divided by vectorial 3 plus when r is 4, 4 into lambda power 4 by factorial 4, etc., etc., etc. So now, simplifying 2 and 2 here. So lambda is a common multiple. So removing lambda outside, lambda and this e power minus lambda into, so this contributes 1. So 1 plus, then you can cancel these two. So this will be factorial 1, lambda by factorial 1. And this is simplified as factorial 2. So 3, 3 will go 3 into factorial 2. So 3, 3 can cancel. Factorial 2, lambda square, 1 lambda we have taken outside. So lambda square by factorial 2. Plus similarly, this is 4 into factorial 3. 4, 4 you can cancel. 1 lambda comes out. So lambda cube by factorial 3, etc., etc., etc. So you can easily see this is nothing but power series of e power x, expansion of e power x. So in that case, we can write this as e power lambda. So e power x is 1 plus x by factorial 1 plus x square by factorial 2, etc., etc., etc. So this is nothing but the expansion of e power lambda. So therefore, this is equal to lambda e power minus lambda, and this is e power lambda. So e power minus lambda into e power lambda makes it 1. So therefore, lambda into 1, so lambda. So mean of Poisson distribution is lambda. Similarly, we can find variance. Variance sigma square is equal to ex square minus ex the whole square. The same old formula for a discrete random variable. So e of x is lambda. Already we have determined e of x is lambda. So we need to find out what is e of x square. So e of x square is equal to, again by definition, sigma r from 0 to infinity r square px p of r. So here this should be p of r, so we will change here. E of x square r from 0 to infinity r square p of r is equal to summation r from 0 to infinity. You write r square as r plus r into r minus 1. So this r plus r square minus r, so rr will get cancelled. We get back r square pr only. So writing like this, sigma r from 0 to infinity, adding and subtracting r plus r into r minus 1 into pr. So multiply if each term by pr and make two summations, sigma 0 to infinity r into pr plus sigma r from 0 to infinity r into r minus 1 into pr. So this is equal to, so this is our mean. This is our mean. So e of x plus sigma r from 0 to infinity r into r minus 1, the substituting for p of r from the probability mass function. So it is e power minus lambda, lambda power r by factorial r. So e power x is lambda plus e power minus lambda is constant with respect to r. So that can be removed outside. E power minus lambda into expanding for first term when r is 0, first term is 0. When r is 1, 1 minus 1, the second term also 0. Third term when r is 2, 2 into 2 minus 1, that is 2 into 1. Lambda square by factorial 2. Then when r is 3, 3 into 3 minus 1, that is 3 into 2, lambda cube by factorial 3, etc., etc., etc. So we can easily make out lambda square is a common multiple to all the terms. So removing lambda square outside and then simplifying, we can write it as lambda plus e power minus lambda, already we have taken outside. Lambda square comes out as a common factor into, so this becomes 1 now. Lambda square has come out, so this is 2 divided by factorial 2 is 2, so this is 1 plus, and this is 6, so this can be written as factorial 1. So lambda square we have taken already outside, so you get the lambda plus, you can easily imagine next is lambda power 4 by factorial 4 into 4 into 3. So if you simplify, this is 12 and this is 24. If you simplify, you get factorial 2 here. Lambda square we have taken already outside. So lambda square by factorial 2. Lambda square by factorial 2, etc., etc., etc. So once again, we can notice that this is the expansion of e power lambda. So replacing this by e power lambda, we get lambda plus e power minus lambda, lambda square, e power lambda is equal to, so e power lambda and plus lambda, e minus lambda will make it 1. So you get lambda plus lambda square. So this is e of x square. So variance is e of x square minus e x the whole square. So therefore sigma square is the variance is equal to lambda plus lambda square minus e of x the whole square, that is lambda square. So lambda square get cancelled. So you are left with lambda. So variance of Poisson distribution is also lambda. Standard deviation is root of variance, that is root lambda. So for a Poisson distribution, mean and variance both are equal to lambda. Okay. Problems. So we need to remember lambda. Lambda is equal to n into p, where n is the number of trials, p is the probability. Problem number one. If a random variable x has a Poisson distribution such that p of 1 is equal to p of 2, find p of 4. Okay. The probability mass function of Poisson distribution is p of r, that is x is equal to r, or simply we can write p of r is equal to e power minus lambda into lambda power r by factorial r. So this is the probability mass function. So in this, you substitute for r is equal to 1 to find p of 1. So this is the equation given, p of 1 is equal to p of 2. So p of 1 is obtained by replacing r by 1 in this expression. So e power minus lambda, lambda power 1, that is lambda, factorial 1, 1 factorial, that is factorial 1, is equal to p of 2. So replace r by 2 here, e power minus lambda, lambda square by factorial 2. So if you simplify, e power minus lambda, you can cancel with this. Then 1 lambda, you can cancel. This is 1. 1 is equal to lambda by 2, or lambda is equal to 2. So we can substitute, after finding lambda, substitute this lambda in p of r to obtain probability mass function for this problem. So p of r is equal to e power minus 2 into 2 power r divided by factorial r. So we need to find p of 4. So therefore p of 4 is equal to e power minus 2, 2 power 4, replacing r by 4, divided by factorial 4. So if you simplify, you get the numerical value 0.0902. Now consider the second problem. If x is a Poisson variate such that e x square is equal to 6, find e of x. So we have to find the mean, that is lambda. E of x is lambda. So if x is a Poisson variate such that e of x square is 6, this is given, we have to find mean of the Poisson distribution. Solution. We know variance is equal to e of x square minus e of x the whole square. Just now we have used this, we have derived variance is e x square minus e of x the whole square. So variance is lambda. We derived variance is lambda. Variance sigma square is lambda. Mean is also equal to lambda. So lambda is equal to e x square is given 6 minus e of x is, just now we have determined, it is also equal to lambda. Both variance and mean are equal to lambda in the case of Poisson probability distribution. So this is lambda square. So rearranging, you can write it as lambda square, taking to left hand side, plus lambda, and taking minus 6 to left hand side, minus 6. So lambda square plus lambda minus 6 equal to 0. So factorizing this, we get lambda plus 3 into lambda minus 2 is equal to 0. So therefore lambda is equal to minus 3. lambda is equal to plus 2, but lambda is always positive, so therefore we cannot consider lambda is equal to minus 3. So the required value of lambda is 2, but lambda is nothing but our mean. So mean or E of x is equal to lambda, so lambda is equal to 2. Third problem. If x is a Poisson variate such that P of x is equal to 0, that is in our case r is equal to 0, one and the same both, x is equal to r, P of x is equal to 0 is 0.5, find the variance of x. So we have to find the variance here with the help of P of x is equal to 0 is 0.5. So let us write the probability mass function of Poisson distribution, that is P of x is equal to r is equal to e power minus lambda, lambda power r divided by factorial r. So it is given that P of x is equal to 0 or r is equal to 0 is equal to 0.5. So put r is equal to 0 here. So e power minus lambda, so therefore e power minus lambda, lambda power 0, r is equal to 0, r is equal to 0, divided by factorial 0, factorial 0 is equal to 0.5. So 0.5 is 1 by 2. So therefore e power minus lambda is equal to 0.5, that is nothing but 1 by 2. Therefore reciprocating, we get e power lambda is equal to 2. So taking log to the base on either side, we get lambda is equal to log 2. So variance is equal to lambda, therefore variance is equal to lambda is equal to log 2. If x is a Poisson variate such that twice P of x is equal to 0 plus probability of x is equal to 2 is equal to twice the probability of x is equal to 1, find E of x. So we have to find the mean, that is lambda. We have to find lambda. So given that 2 of probability of x is equal to 0, 2 times probability of x is equal to 0 plus probability of x is equal to 2 is equal to twice the probability of x is equal to 1. So this equation is given. So first let us write the probability mass function of Poisson distribution as P of x is equal to r is equal to e power minus lambda, lambda power r divided by factorial r. So it is given that twice P of r is equal to 0 or x is equal to 0, because we have equated x is equal to r. So you can take this as r is equal to 0 plus P of r is equal to 2 is equated to twice probability of r is equal to 1. So let us substitute r is equal to 0. So e power minus lambda, lambda power 0, factorial 0. E power minus lambda, lambda power 0, factorial 0, plus P of x is equal to 2, that is r is equal to 2. So put r is equal to 2 here. E power minus lambda, lambda square divided by factorial 2 is equal to twice probability of r is equal to 1, twice e power minus lambda, lambda power by lambda power 1 divided by factorial 1. So we can easily cancel out e power minus lambda and we are left with, so this is 1, so this is 2, plus this has gone, lambda square by factorial 2 is 2, so lambda square by 2 is equal to e power minus lambda is cancelled, we have cancelled this, so we are left with 2 into lambda by 1 or 2 lambda. So rearranging this, or multiplying throughout by 2 and rearranging, we obtain lambda square, this is 4 lambda, so minus 4 lambda, and this is plus 4 equal to 0. So this is nothing but lambda minus 2 whole square equal to 0. So this gives you lambda is equal to 2. Hence, E of x, that is mean, is equal to lambda. Lambda is equal to 2. Okay. So our next question. In a factory turning out razor blades, there is a small chance of 0.002 for any blade to be defective. The blades are supplied in packets of 10. Use Poisson distribution to calculate the approximate number of packets containing no defective, one defective, and two defective blades respectively in a consignment of 10,000 packets. So let us quickly note down what is given. So probability of any blade to be defective is given to be 0.002. That is chance. Small chance means probability. So therefore P is given, and N blades are supplied in packets of 10. N is given. So you can find lambda and construct probability mass function for the Poisson probability distribution. Then to calculate the approximate number of packets containing no defective, first we have to find the probability of no defective and multiply that probability to the 10,000 packets to obtain approximate number of packets containing no defective blades. So similarly, for one defective and two defective, we have to follow the same procedure. So in the solution part, given probability 0.002 and N is given to be 10. So therefore, lambda is equal to N into P. We know what is lambda. Lambda is N into P. So this is equal to N is 10, P is 0.002. So this is equal to 0.02. So lambda is 0.02. So therefore, we know the lambda. So probability mass function of Poisson distribution can be constructed, and it is P of R is equal to e power minus lambda, lambda power R divided by factorial R. So substituting for lambda, our P of R becomes P of R is equal to e power minus 0.002 power R divided by factorial R. Now, the question, find the probability of no defective. First, the probability of no defective is, so a random variable is number of defective blades, number of defectives, undefective blades. So probability of no defective, so this is defective, so we'll make changes here. Probability of no defective is P of R is equal to 0. Random variable should be equal to 0. So P of R is equal to 0. So this is equal to the substitute R is equal to 0 here. So e power minus 0.002 into 0.02 power 0 divided by factorial 0. So this is 0 again. Factorial 0. So this will be, this is 1. So 1 by e power 0.02, or when we calculate using calculator, this will be the numerical value 0.9802. So therefore, number of packets containing no defective in a consignment of 10,000 packets is equal to 10,000 into probability of no defective, that is 0.9802. This is a So this will be this is actually 2 again. So therefore, the number of packets containing no defective in a consignment of 10,000 packets is equal to 10,000 into this probability. That will give you 9,802 packets that contains approximately no defect. These are the approximate number of pockets which contains no defective blade. Next, probability of one defective is random variable r is equal to 1. So p of r is equal to 1 is equal to, substituting for r here and here, e power minus 0.02 into 0.02 power 1 divided by factorial 1 will give you 0.02 divided by e power 0.02. So this makes 0.019604. So therefore, if you multiply this probability to 1000 pockets, we get the approximate number of pockets which contains one defective blade. So therefore, number of packets containing one defective blade in a consignment of 10,000 packets is equal to 10,000 into 0.019604. So that will give you 196.04 approximately, because number of packets cannot be fraction. So this is approximately equal to 196. So approximate number of packets, 196 is the approximate number of packets which contain one defective blade. The third problem, we have to first find the probability of two defective blades. So therefore, probability of two defective blade is probability of r is equal to 2. So replacing r by 2 here and here in the formula will give you 0.00030 19604. So therefore, number of packets containing two defective in a consignment of 10,000 packets is equal to this 10,000 into this probability. That will give you 1.9604, approximately two packets. Next question. 2% of the fuses manufactured by a firm are found to be defective. So random variable, once again here, number of defectives. Find the probability that a box containing 200 fuses contains no defective fuses, 3 or more defective fuses. So it is given that 2% of the fuses manufactured by a firm are found to be defective. So probability is given. So P is 2%. Find the probability that a box containing 200 fuses. So N is given to be 200. So probability P is given to be 2%, and N is given to be 200. So we can find easily lambda and construct probability mass function and evaluate these two probabilities. Okay. It is given that P is 2%, that is 2 by 100 or 0.02. N is given to be 200, so therefore lambda is N into P will give you 200 into N is 200 into probability 0.02, that gives you the value 4. So substitute the value 4 in the probability mass function, we get the probability mass function for this problem as P of R is equal to e power minus 4 into 4 power R divided by factorial r. So I have replaced only lambda, e power minus 4 and here 4. 1. Probability of no defective, that means random variable should be equal to 0, that r is equal to 0. So p of r is equal to 0 is equal to e power minus 4, 4 power 0, factorial 0. So that will give you 1 over e power 4 or e power minus 4. When you calculate using calculator, the numerical value will be 0.0183. The second problem is 3 or more defective fuses, that is r greater than or equal to 3. The random variable r, number of defective greater than or equal to 3. So probability of 3 or more defective is probability of r greater than or equal to 3. So we can take the complement here. So this will be equal to 1 minus P of R strictly less than 3. So this is equal to 1 minus up to 2 only. 3 is not included. So P of 0 plus P of 1 plus P of 2. So substituting for P of 0, P of 1, P of 2, replacing R by 0 here, R by 1 here, r by 2 here, we obtain 1 minus e power minus 4 into 4 power 0 by factorial 0 plus p1 e power minus 4, 4 power 1, that is 4 divided by factorial 1 plus p of 2 e power minus 4 into 4 square divided by factorial 2. So if you simplify, so this will reduce to 13 by e power 4. So 1 minus 13 by e power 4 is equal to the numerical value 0.7618. So probability of 3 or more defective is 0.7618. Next question. Suppose 300 misprints are randomly distributed throughout a book of 500 pages. So number of misprints is 300. So our n is 300. Find the probability that a given page contains exactly 3 misprints, less than 3 misprints, and 4 or more misprints. So n is given to be 300. What is the probability p? Probability p. So given a page contains, so we have to find the probability of each page out of 500. That means 1 by 500 is the probability. 1 by 500 is the probability. So p is 1 by 500, n is 300. So I can find the value of lambda is equal to n into p and construct the probability mass function to evaluate these three cases. Okay. So probability p is 1 by 500, n is 300, so lambda is n into p, so 1 by 500 into 300, so 3 by 5 are 0.6. So therefore, the probability mass function of Poisson distribution is p of x is equal to r is equal to e power minus lambda, lambda power r divided by factorial r. So substituting for lambda, we get probability mass function for this problem as p of r is equal to e power minus 0.6, 0.6 power r divided by factorial r. Now, the cases, exactly 3 misprints, that means r is equal to 3, less than 3 misprints, r is less than 3, 4 or more, so r greater than or equal to 4. So these are the problems here. Probability of exactly 3 misprints. So a random variable is number of misprints. So r is equal to 3. So r is equal to 3. Replace r by 3 here. So e power minus 0.6, 0.6 power 3 divided by factorial 3. So if you using the calculator, if you calculate, this will get reduced to the numerical value 0.0917. The second case. Probability of less than 3 misprints, that is random variable less than 3, probability of r less than 3 is equal to 0 to 2. 3 is not included, so p of 0 plus p of 1 plus p of 2. When you substitute r is equal to 0 in the probability mass function p of r here, you get the first term e power minus 0.6, 0.6 power 0 divided by factorial 0 plus e power minus 0.6, and then 0.6 power 1 factorial 1, similarly 0.6 whole square by factorial 2. So when you simplify, when you use the calculator and calculate these terms individually, it reduces to, so for this term 1, the numerical value is 0.5488. for the second term, numerical value is 0.3292. for the third term, the numerical value after calculating using the calculator is 0.0987. when you add all these, you get 0.9767. so therefore, the probability of less than 3 misprints is 0.9767. next question. Probability of 4 or more than 3. So let me see the question. 4 or more misprints. 4 or more. So this need to be corrected here. 4 or more. probability of four or more misprints is probability of random variable greater than or equal to 4 or more greater than or equal to 4. So this can be written as, using the complement property, 1 minus probability of r strictly less than 4, that means up to 3 only, 4 is not included here. So 1 minus p of 0 plus p of 1, 2 plus p of 3. So p of 0 to p of 2 we have already calculated here, so that can be taken directly, 0.9767, that is 1 minus bracket 0.9767 plus, when r is 3, e power minus 0.6, 0.6 power 3. So we had to replace 2 by 3 and 2 by 3 here also, factorial 3. That means we are replacing r by 3 in this formula, in this probability mass function. So when we calculate all together, this will reduce to a numerical value 0.0036. So probability of 4 or more misprints is 0.0036. Next problem. A communication channel receives independent pulses at the rate of 12 pulses per microsecond. The probability of transmission error is 0.001. So probability is given, transmission error, probability of transmission error. Here the random variable is number of transmission errors. So P is given to be 0.001 and N is given to be 12 pulses. So N is 12. Compute the probability of no error during a microsecond, one error per microsecond, at least one error per microsecond, two errors, and at most two errors. The problem is, a communication channel receives independent pulses at the rate of 12 pulses per microsecond. The probability of transmission error is 0.001 for each microsecond. Compute the probability of one, no error during, that means random variable 0, one error per microsecond, random variable is equal to 1, at least one error greater than or equal to 1, then two errors are exactly equal to 2, at most two errors are less than or equal to 2. Okay, so given probability 0.001, so given the probability P 0.001, that's what is given, 0.001, and N is given to be 12, so you can easily make out N is given to be 12. So therefore lambda is equal to N into P is equal to 12 into 0.001, that makes 0.012. so therefore the probability mass function for this problem is P of R is equal to e power minus 0.012 into 0.012 power r divided by factorial r. Now, so looking at the problem, so now probability mass function is constructed, one error. So here random variable is number of transmission error. So one error per microsecond, and no error. First problem is no error during a microsecond. That means r is equal to 0. No error. R is equal to 0. So put r is equal to 0 here. So you get e power minus 0.012 into 0.012 power 0 factorial 0. So this is calculated and obtained as 0.9881. So probability of no transmission error per microsecond is 0.9881. Similarly, probability of one error per microsecond is r is equal to 1. P of r is equal to 1. So replace r by 1 here. So you get this e power minus 0.012 power 1, that is 0.012 divided by factorial 1. Using calculator, if you calculate, this will reduce to the numerical value 0.0118. So probability of one transmission error per microsecond is 0.0118. Similarly, probability of at least one error per microsecond is probability of r greater than or equal to 1. So to compute this, it is better to take the complement. So therefore, this is written as 1 minus probability of r strictly less than 1. So this is equal to 1 minus p of 0. So p of 0 we have already obtained 0.9881. So substitute here, when you simplify, 1 minus 0.9881, you get 0.0119. Fourth problem, probability of two errors. Probability of two errors per microsecond is p of r is equal to 2. So when you replace r is equal to 2 here, r is equal to 2, you get this term e power minus 0.012 into 0.012 power 2 divided by factorial 2. So this is calculated to be 0.000071, very small value. Last problem, at most two errors. So probability of at most two errors is less than or equal to 2. So at most is less than or equal to, at least greater than or equal to. So probability of r less than or equal to 2 is equal to p of 0 plus p of 1 plus p of 2. So p of 0 is calculated and obtained as 0.9881. p of 1 also, I think we have done 0.0118118, and p of 2 is obtained as 0.0004071. So when you simplify, you get the value, numerical value, 0.9999. So probability of at most two transmission errors is 0.9999. Next problem. A car hires as two cars which it hires out day by day. The number of demands for a car on each day is distributed as a Poisson distribution with mean 1.5. Calculate the proportion of days, that is probability, calculate the proportion of days on which neither car is used and the proportion of days on which some demand is refused. A car hire as two cars which it hires out day by day. The number of demands for a car on each day is distributed as a Poisson distribution with mean. So mean is given, lambda is given directly, and we need to calculate the probability of days on which neither car is used and the proportion of days on which some demand is refused. So given mean lambda is equal to 1.5, so therefore you can construct the probability mass function p of r is equal to e power minus 1.5 into 1.5 power r divided by factorial r. So probability of neither car is used, when cars are not used, when there is no demand, cars are not used, therefore the random variable number of demands for a car should be equal to 0. So p of r is equal to 0 is equal to e power minus 1.5 into 1.5 power 0 by factorial 0 will be calculated to the numerical value 0.2231. So probability of neither car is used is 0.2231. Probability of some demand is refused is nothing but probability that there are more than two demands. When we will refuse the demands? When there is more than the required number of demands. So more than, if there is two only, we have only two cars, so only two demands we can take. Any demand after that we will refuse. That means when the random variable is greater than two, that means we have to find the probability of r greater than 2. The demand is more than what is available, that is only two cars are there, we can hire out only two cars. When there is more demand, so we refuse the demand. That means we have to calculate the probability of r greater than 2. So this is equal to, you can take the complement of this, so 1 minus p of r less than or equal to 2, that is equal to 1 minus p of 0 plus p of 1 plus p of 2. So this is simplified as 1 minus, so replacing r by 0, we get this term, r by 1, we get this term, r by 2, we get this term. So when we simplify, so e power minus 1.5, you can take it outside as a common factor, into this is 1, this is 1.5, this has taken, this has come out, and this is 1.5 by factorial 1, that is 1.5 plus 1.5 whole square divided by 2. So when we use the calculator and simplify, we get the numerical value 0.1911. Okay, the next problem. Find the expectation of the function phi of x equal to x into e power minus x in a Poisson distribution. Okay. Expectation in the solution part, expectation of a random variable x is e of x, that is sigma x into px, the definition of a mean or average, and p of x, so for our convenience sake, I have replaced r by x here. So p of x is equal to e power minus lambda into lambda power x divided by factorial x. Therefore, expectation of e of x, phi of x is equal to sigma x varying from 0 to infinity, this phi of x into p of x is this, into p of x is this. But phi of x is given to be x into e power minus x. So therefore, sigma x from 0 to infinity, x into e power minus x, x into e power minus x into e power minus lambda, lambda power x by factorial x. So this is equal to e power minus lambda, nothing to do with the summation because it is free from x. So that can be written outside. So this is written as sigma x from 1 to infinity, simplifying x and factorial x. This can be written as x minus 1 factorial into x. Xx will get cancelled. So 1 over x minus 1 factorial. When x is 0, minus 1 factorial is meaningless. So we ignore that term. So we start from 1 to infinity. 1 to infinity. 1 by factor x minus 1. And this lambda and e are clubbed together. So lambda by e power x. So this can be written as e power minus lambda sigma x from 1 to infinity. 1 by factorial x minus 1. So this is written as lambda by e power x minus 1 into lambda by e. So this lambda by e is taken out and written outside the summation. Lambda by outside the summation into e power minus lambda. This e power minus lambda. And sigma, a summation varying x from 1 to infinity, m. So this is written as m. M is lambda by e. So m power x minus 1 by x minus factorial x minus 1. M power x minus 1 by factorial x minus 1, where m is lambda by e. So lambda by e, e power minus lambda. So when you expand this, when x is equal to 1, m power 0 by factorial 0, that is 1, plus when x is 2, m by factorial 1, that is 2 minus 1, 1, 2 minus 1 factorial, that is factorial 1, similar plus when m is 3, 1, 2, 3, 3 minus 1, m square by factorial 2, plus when m is 4, 4 minus 1, 3, that is m cube by factorial 3, etc., etc. And this is nothing but the expansion of e power m. So lambda by e, e power minus lambda, e power m is equal to lambda by e, e power, I simplify these two terms, e power m minus lambda. So lambda by e, e power, so I will take out minus lambda outside, so e power minus lambda into 1 minus m by lambda. So if you multiply minus lambda plus m, so we get back this term. So this is further written as lambda by e, e power minus lambda into 1 minus m by lambda. M by lambda is 1 by e. So if you calculate, 1 by e reduces to 0.3679 into lambda. E power 1 minus 1 by e is 0.632. So this minus n is here into this lambda. So which is the required expectation function? Next question. A certain screw making machine produces an average of 2 defective screws out of 100 and pack them in boxes of 2 500. Find the probability that a box contains 15 defective screws. The question is, a certain screw making machine produces an average of 2 defective screws out of 100. So this is the probability. 2 defective out of 100, that is 2 by 100 is the probability, and I pack them in boxes of 500. So this is our n. So n is given, p is given, so you can construct lambda, and you can find lambda and construct the probability mass function of probability Poisson probability distribution. So given that 2 out of 100 screws are defective, that means probability p is 2 by 100 is 0.02, and n is given to be 500. So therefore lambda is n into p is 500 into 0.02 makes 10. So therefore the probability mass function of Poisson distribution is p of r is equal to e power minus 10, replace lambda by 10, 10 power r divided by factorial r. The probability that a box contains 15 defective is, so here random variable is number of defective screws. So the probability that a box contains 15 defective screws is probability of r is equal to 15, that is equal to, so replace r by 15 here. So e power minus 10, 10 power 15 by factorial 15 will give you the numerical value after calculating 0.0347. So therefore the probability that a box contains 15 defective is 0.0347. So fitting a Poisson distribution to the observed data, a Poisson distribution can be fitted to the observed values in the data set as follows. The first step we have to find the mean, like we did in the binomial distribution. So after finding the mean, we can write the probability mass function of Poisson distribution. So this is the one. Then multiply the n's, the theoretical frequencies are n into pr. So multiply n to this probability for r is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. We get the theoretical frequencies. So let us consider this problem. Fit a Poisson distribution for the following data. So data is x taking the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, corresponding frequencies 122, 60, 15, 2, 1. So mean for Poisson distribution is lambda is equal to lambda, or mean of this distribution is sigma x into f by f, sigma f, summation of sum of the products vertically 0 into 122 plus 1 into 60 plus 2 into 15 plus 3 into 2 plus 4 into 1 divided by sigma f, that is sum of the frequencies, that is the mean. So mean is sigma x into f divided by sigma f, or summation x into f by summation of f is equal to this product, this is 0, plus 1 into 60, 60, plus 2 into 15, 30, 3 into 2, 6, plus 4 into 1, 4, divided by sum of the frequencies is equal to 200. So therefore this is 190 plus 10, 100 by 2, that is 0.5. So lambda is 0.5, mean is 0.5. So lambda is our mean, so lambda is equal to 0.5. So you can substitute in the probability mass function p of r is equal to e power minus lambda, lambda power r by factorial r is equal to e power minus 0.5, 0.5 power r divided by factorial r. Hence the theoretical frequencies are n into pr, that is equal to n into e power, so pr is e power minus 0.5, 0.5 power r divided by factorial r for r is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when r is 0, so n into p of 0, that will give you 121.30. So that means we have to put 0 here, multiply by 100, sigma f 200, sigma f 200, multiply by 200, then we will get 121.30. Then for r is equal to 1, r is equal to 1, n into p of 1. So 200 into e power minus 0.5 into 0.5 power 1 by factorial 1, that will give you 60.65. When r is 2, n into p of 2, so 200 into n is 200, sigma f is 200. So 200 into e power minus 0.5 into 0.5 power 2 divided by factorial 2, that will give you 15.16. Similarly, when r is 3, n into p of 3, that is 200 into e power minus 0.5 into 0.5 power 3 divided by factorial 3, that will be the numerical value 2.52. Similarly, when r is 4, n into p of 4, so 200 into e power minus 0.5, 0.5 power 4 divided by factorial 4, so that will give you 0.31. So rounding off these values and conveniently written as, thus the theoretical frequencies obtained are x is x0 1 2 3 4, the corresponding frequency is 121, then 60.65 is written as 61, then 15.16 is written as 15, 2.52 is 3, 0.31 is 0. So therefore, this is the fit of a Poisson distribution for the given observed data. Next question. The number of monthly breakdowns of a computer is a random variable having Poisson distribution with mean equal to 1.8. Find the probability that this computer will function for a month without breakdown, with only one breakdown, with at least one breakdown. Okay. So what is given? The mean is given as 1.8. So lambda is directly given. Lambda is directly given. So therefore, we can write lambda 1.8 and substitute in the probability mass function to obtain p of r is equal to e power minus 1.8. 1.8 power r divided by factorial r. So question number 1, the probability that computer will function without breakdown. The probability that computer will function without breakdown, that means r is equal to 0. Here random variable is number of breakdowns. R is equal to 0. So that will give you e power minus 1.8. 1.8 power 0. So this is 0. And factorial 0 here also. P of 0. E power minus 1.8, 1.8 power 0, factorial 0. So this is simplified to 0.1652. The next question, probability that computer will function with only one breakdown. With only one breakdown is equal to R, is P of R is equal to 1. So replacing R by 1, so we get E power minus 1.8. 1.8 power 1 divided by factorial 1, this is calculated as 0.2975. therefore, the probability that computer will function with only one breakdown is 0.2975. lastly, computer will function with at least one breakdown. With at least one breakdown means r greater than or equal to 1. So probability that computer will function with at least one breakdown is probability of r greater than or equal to 1. So we can take the complement of probability of r greater than or equal to 1 is equal to, and written as 1 minus p of r strictly less than 1. So 1 minus p of 0. So p of 0 is 0.1652. So 1 minus 0.1652 is 0.8348. so therefore, probability that computer will function with at least one breakdown is 0.8348. Next question. The probability that an individual suffers a bad reaction from a certain injection is 0.002. Determine the probability that out of 1000 individuals, exactly 3, more than 2, will suffer a bad reaction. The question is, the probability that an individual suffers a bad reaction from a certain injection is 0.002. Determine the probability that out of 1000 individuals, exactly 3, more than 2, will suffer a bad reaction. So what is given is, probability is given 0.002 and n is given to be 1000. So you can calculate lambda. Lambda turns out to be 2. So substituting in the probability mass function, you get e power minus 2, 2 power r by factorial r. The question is, find the probability of, determine the probability that out of 1000 individuals, exactly 3, more than 2 will suffer a bad reaction. So probability that exactly 3 will suffer a bad reaction is probability of r is equal to 3. So this is equal to e power minus 2, 2 cube by factorial 3. So this is calculated to be 0.1804. Similarly, the next question, the probability that more than 2 will suffer a bad reaction is probability of r greater than 2, more than 2, so greater than 2. So better to take the complement and write as 1 minus probability of r strictly less than or equal to 2. So 1 minus p of 0 plus p of 1 plus p of 2, because 2 is also included. So when you simplify, when you substitute for p of 0, p of 1, p of 2, we get 1 minus e power minus 2, 2 power 0 by factorial 0, plus e power minus 2, 2 power 1 by factorial 1, plus e power minus 2, 2 square by factorial 2. When we simplify, we get 0.3233. So the probability that more than 2 will suffer bad reaction is 0.3233. So I am going to stop here. This completes discrete probability distribution. In my next class, I will consider continuous probability distribution. Thank you.